I'm one third of the hardest dance group of all times, the Soul Brothers.
In this hip hop dance story series, I'm going to explore the best dance scenes in the history of television and film.
Break it down and give it a cutty review.
In the history of television and films, street dance has always made a dynamic impact on the screen. Most times, the best dancers only got a 25-second scene in a two-hour movie, and it would end up being the most memorable part. It was just enough time to get some shine. Just Enough Time to Shine, Episode 6, featuring...
Challenge!
Scene from the movie Tap. How about that? Jack? Whoo! So let's not waste no time. We ain't here to play no reindeer games.
Meet me in the circle, last buggy.
The legendary OG Cutty Mack with another episode of Just Enough Time to Shine, showcasing the best and most instrumental dance scenes in television and film.
Come in here.
This scene is what spawned the idea for this show format. It was this 2-minute scene that not only carried the entire movie, but it touched and inspired lives in and out of the dance community. I am most proud of this subject today for many, many reasons, and I'll tap in on the most important ones that relate to this discussion. The elder dance gods that I'm showcasing today represents the blueprint, the alpha and the omega. Don't just listen to this game I'm giving today. I brought receipts. We got Mr. Show Business, Sammy Davis Jr., the entertainer's entertainer, Arthur Duncan, the Hall of Famer, Bunny Briggs, the icon, Sandman Sims, White Dynamite, Steve Kondos, whoo, the Tap God, Harold Nicholas, the King of All Slides, Jimmy Sly, Smooth Elegance, Honey Coles, and the lead in the film, Gregory Hines, the sleepy-eyed soldier and the master of sound. Oh yeah, a young Savion Glover was in it, but we're gonna rap about him in a minute. Now, every dancer that I will discuss in this episode had a moment, a heyday, a prime, the beginnings, just like everybody else. But the question is, what does your dancing do for you in the middle? And how are you gonna finish in the end? These dancers here crossed that line and finished strong in the end. There have been millions, probably closer to a billion dancers that have boogied somewhere across the earth, but there are only a few pioneers, trailblazers, and icons that you know by name or by their work. Each new generation is going to rediscover this era for the first time and be mystified. I'm talking outside their respective dance community. There are only a handful of names that reign in this boogie game. My personal street dance journey starts with the Jackson 5, then the Lockers and Poppin'. But then somewhere along the journey, I saw these hoofers way past their prime, still cold-blooded, and still on time. I asked the obvious question, who the fuck is that? As a young player, I was in awe. But now, Looking in hindsight, I see I was getting my education into the boogie game, and these were the true master teachers, which included not just the dance, but the lifestyle that came with it. The rules, regulations, and guidelines that we want to be one of the greats and do it to the end. Yes, sir. Now, when the golden era of hip-hop emerged, I got that same exact feeling like I did when I was a youngin' and first laid eyes on the Master Hoofers all on stage together. So when I saw the likes of a Buddha Stretch, Clef Love, Scoob and Scrap Lover, Fendi, Salima and Afro, the Soul Brothers, IBM, I got the same exact feeling. I said, that's it. That's it. It was something special, magical, spiritual. Fellow dance lord Clef Love and I used to dream of the days when our era would do great things like the elders before us. We wanted to make classic movies like Stormy Weather and Cabin in the Sky. Shit, we even wanted to do Let's Do It Again. And most importantly, we couldn't wait until we were in our late 50s, 60s, and 70s, still getting busy on stage just like the elders that set the blueprint. Here are the receipts. See for yourself. Now let's talk about that middle passage. After the heyday, what you gonna do, what you gonna do? Now, before I met some of the elder OGs and asked for myself, I always had questions. What were they doing between their late 20s after their heyday to 60 at the rebirth? That is 40 years off the radar. And they came back at 60, dancing at a very high level. Not singing, rapping, or acting, but dancing, getting a boogie on, doing routines, still doing splits and floor work and shit. Now, if you watch hip-hop dance stories here on Cutty Mac TV, your favorite dancers of the 80s and 90s have similar stories or may have taken different journeys, but they eventually ended up on the same path as the elder OGs. See? It's a ready-made thing. All we got to do is add water. Yes, sir. Now, at the age of 30, I used to watch the movie Tap almost every day. My homie used to laugh because every time he came through, it was on my TV. I would just throw the tape on, let it run, then let it rewind itself, and let it play again. See, at that time in my life, I stopped watching all the footage of my favorite dancers when they were in their early 20s. I only watched them after 30 years of age. See, I wanted to see how their body responded, what they did to stay ready. And while the homie was laughing, I was preparing myself for the next stage. Yes, sir! I'm serious about this boogie game, Jack. Woo! You dig? So now, the movie Tap, there's no reason to do a review because the movie itself was boo-boo. Whoo, Lord have mercy. Now that's what makes this scene so special.
Challenge!
It is the only part worth talking about.
Challenge!
It's the only part the people remember.
Challenge!
Challenge! Challenge.
Some people know this scene and don't know what movie it came from, you dig? That is how powerful and instrumental it is. It put the elder gods back on the map. They were able to dance, make money, and live their best life until their passing. From a dance moment, they had just enough time to get their shine, Jack. Now, let's go to the root of challenge.
Challenge!
So now, during this period, it was common for dancers to carry their tap shoes with them in their back pocket. A foe, another dancer in the streets, they would throw their shoes down by way of the challenge. The great Sandman Sim stated, challenge dancing, in which each performer tries to outdo the other. It is part of the tap dancing heritage, was just as much collegial as it was combative. Now pay close attention to this game I'm about to drop to you. The culture of street dancing in the 1920s has only been compared to the rise of hip-hop dance era 6 decades later. Now dig that. It also let the generations that look up to them know that we have to boogie to the finish line. There is no retirement from the game. You must dance and make love until you are 90 years old. The great Sandman Sims also said that his father lived to be 106 years old and he still could not dance him. So dig that. Each man on here we will see today boogie to his very last breath. Now, back to the movie Tap. I understand why they tried to upgrade and start a resurgence of tapping, because at one time, hoofing and tap dancing was cooking. Their time period was on fire, the hottest ticket in the entertainment game. And then one day, it was over. Just like that. No warning, no signs of going stale. It was just over. Now, every dancer in this scene we are reviewing is well into their 60s. But it was this movie that extended their career another 30 years to the end. They were able to get new money, solidify their legacy, and most importantly, allow them to do what they love to do, what they were put on this earth to do, all the way to the finish line. It's a marathon, you popcorn dancers, and it looks like your legs are getting tired. Let's go,
sprinters, sprinters.
Like at the beginning,
your legs getting tired.
You think we ain't got no legs? Is that what you're saying? Sandman, come in here, come in here. You know what this young man said? We ain't got no legs. That means I ain't got no legs, you ain't got no legs, and that men in there ain't got no legs. Now, what does that sound like to you?
A challenge.
Now, I ain't challenged nobody.
Bring in the guys. Come on in here. Go ahead. Take some.
All right. Go ahead.
We got a function. We ain't got no legs. You challenge us.
I didn't challenge anyone.
Challenge is going on here. Make a circle. Make a circle. Come out here and show him, Arthur, how we get down.
Bend those legs, Arthur. Bend them. That's it, baby. Bend them.
All right, Arthur. Bend them.
Let's go.
Let's go.
All time. So, I hope you enjoyed the hoofing challenge. I was so proud to do this segment. But next episode, the producer of this show and fly co-host on the Hip Hop Dance Stories, Yo Afro, is going to flow in the next show and hit you with the Honey Review. Then your Kelly Mack will be back on the right train, on the right track. And so far, we tapped into the hoofing era. We rocked that locking era. Then we got wind of hip-hop's golden era. Now it's time to get a taste of that real R&B era, you dig? I got a couple of cold ones coming up. So, until the next time we meet, remember, he that does the Harlem Shake in a cesspool is a bigger fool than one who engages with an ill who thinks distant thoughts. Think about that. Jack.